With legendary focus and tireless preparation, Ivan Lendl pushed the limits of tennis and its greatest stars. 8 Grand Slams and 97 titles later, his impact on tennis will be felt forever. Overcoming the back pain that forced him into the shadows of tennis, he's ready to step into the spotlight. For the first time in 16 years, Ivan will take the court in Atlantic City, marking the return of a champion.
It's big for the sport, it's big for him. It's good to see him. You know, he was my idol growing up.
He can play now totally for himself, for fun. And that's really the reason to come back and do it.
It's awesome to see him back out there and playing well, moving well, showing what he's capable of doing, and enjoying it.
Everybody's been asking, where's Ivan? And we all know that he's had back problems and he's been playing a lot of golf and raising his 5 daughters, of course, so better things to do, I guess.
I think it's huge. I think you look at the average clubber who reaches 50 with a 1/100th of the skill that Ivan had and realize, hey, this guy can come on back, work his body backwards. I think it's going to do the game of tennis good.
The time is right, just like the time was right here 2 years ago for Pete and Roger to play. It's time is right for me to play in Atlantic City.
You know, for the first time in, like, I think it's 15 years, tennis coming back to Atlantic City. We take a lot of pride in terms of having the ability as an organization to bring, you know, together this great event.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the historic Boardwalk Hall and the 2010 Caesars Tennis Classic.
We see all of these tour events where they're on the men's and the women's circuits. But what we're doing here really is a show, because we want to bring something really, really special to Atlantic City.
Ladies and gentlemen, Venus Williams.
Venus, on behalf of Harris Entertainment and Caesars Atlantic City, I am thrilled to present you with the first Caesars Tennis Classic Achievement Award.
Thank you so much, Jerry. He's one of my biggest supporters. Thank you for having me here tonight. I really enjoy it.
The opportunity for people around the world to see players of this caliber, I think these one-night events are very important.
Had the opportunity to talk to some of the champions, and just hearing, you know, what goes through the mind of a champion, cool, it doesn't describe it. You know, it's just absolutely outstanding when you can sit there and listen to how they think about, you know, approaching major events of this nature, and there's still that intensity to win deep down inside, and it's just great to hear.
You only play to win and do your best, that's for sure, but hey, we'll see what happens. It's an honor, and it should be really fun.
My expectation is to put on a good performance, hopefully win. I'm sure Mats will want to win as well and have fun.
And welcome to the Caesars Tennis Classic at beautiful Caesars Palace Atlantic City Boardwalk Hall. 2 Tennis Hall of Famers going at it, Ivan Lendl and Mats Wilander. A celebration of some great Grand Slam matches of years past.
Ivan Lendl to serve.
J.P. Peterson along with former number 5 in the world, Jimmy Arias. And Jimmy, this is going to be a lot of fun today.
This should be a fantastic match. The first time we've seen Ivan Lendl on a tennis court in 16 years. He should be a little nervous to start. And that would be only natural.
I think we saw it right there.
Yeah, we did. No footwork on that first point. But again, he needs to get into a couple of long rallies, get the cobwebs off, get a feel for playing in front of people again.
No ad scoring. We'll play just one set today, so barring long rallies, we'll see what happens. And here we go. Classic Wilander Lendl. Look at the rally count in the upper corner. He's lost some 40 pounds at 50 years of age recently.
It's like the old days.
They didn't used to talk to each other in the middle of the rallies back in the Grand Slam final days, but this is a little more fun today. But Lendl still feeling a tiny bit of pressure to start.
It was the 88. The U.S. Open. Are you tired yet? He says that was the real epic between these two. A 5-setter. Wilander winning Almost 5 hours, the longest match in U.S. Open history.
Anytime you play Mats Wilander, you have to figure out a way to break down his defense. Lendl did it beautifully there, starting with a short backhand, a little bit like Federer, short, and brought Wilander in, and then was able to control things the rest of the way behind his big forehand.
There you go. And a big serve there from Lendl to get back down love 30 in this game, so that competitive spirit coming back already for Lendl.
Yeah, a couple of big serves. That's something that he did have over Mats Wilander when they did play each other. He had a bit more of a weapon behind his first serve. He's used it well the last 2 points.
Now Lendl will serve for the first game here at Caesars. Game.
This show is brought to you by Caesars Atlantic City, the life you were meant to live. Harrah's Resort Atlantic City, where everybody plays a part. And Yvonne Lendl's Champions Academy, where greatness happens. Eight-time Grand Slam winner Yvonne Lendl is considered one of the best tennis players of all time. Lendl was world number one for 270 weeks during his career.
Let's get it straight. Yvonne Lendl is a great player. He stayed at number one way longer than most people remember. He won 8 majors and made the Wimbledon final 3 times. He won 64 titles on every surface. He won on grass. He won Davis Cup. He's definitely up there as one of the greatest players of all time.
Born into a tennis family in Czechoslovakia, Yvonne became world number one at the junior level by age 17. And later won his first Grand Slam against McEnroe at the 1984 French Open.
Just remember, it was a turning point in that career. McEnroe sort of stayed the same, and Lendl just got better and better and became more confident and just sort of overpower these guys. Just sort of remember that domination. It was like power against grace, and the power won.
Lendl took off after that win, reaching the U.S. Open Finals 8 consecutive years, landing him in the International Hall of Fame in 2001.
He's a scary opponent because he could really play well, like he could kick your butt. And I couldn't do the same to him. I could beat him, but if he had a great day, I was in trouble.
Lendl was forced into retirement due to chronic back pain in 1994, ending a career that ushered in training and athleticism to tennis.
But the back pain really got the best of me for quite a while. There is a doctor in Vero Beach who helped me a lot. My back has gotten better. A lot better over the last 2 years, so I can train more consistently. I can work out today and be fully functional tomorrow. Even as little as 18 months ago, that would not be the case.
All right, we're back at the Caesars Tennis Classic. Wilander to serve here.
15 long.
Now we're going to drop in a little retrospective from 1985, when these two met in the Lipton 85 final at Boca West, and watch how similar their games still are.
Few more slices today than there were back then. Wilander liked to hit two-handers more then.
And a little net cord from Lendl, that always helps to even things up at 15 all. Uncanny resemblance.
30-15.
A little anger there from Lendl. You saw that from time to time when you played him, Jimmy, right?
At times, but he usually was pretty stoic on the court when he played.
40-15.
Showing more emotion now
yeah.
than he ever has before.
And playing to the crowd a little bit more.